Hello everyone. Today I will show you the another lab, which is configuration of VLAN and routing protocol. I'm having, like you see in the diagram, I'm having two routers and switches. I will configure these switches as a VLAN and two routers for routing protocol, and I will use this one server for web service so that these PCs can access web service from this server by crossing routing protocol. So I will implement in Cisco Packet Tracer. I already designed and connected PCs and switches same as diagram to save the time. So let's start configuration here in Packet Tracer. Let me start configure with these switches. Yeah, so start with switch 4. Switch 4, I have three ports. One is a trunk port, and this one is these two access port. So let's start. Enable config t. Yeah, host name switch 4. Okay, and now login. Sorry, console to disable the login, and let me configure enable telnet line VTY 04 password. I will put all the device password with Cisco. Log in is it, and also console password Cisco, and enable password also Cisco. Okay, and sorry, so with password encryption, yes, done. Basic configuration. Now let me start configure port. Okay, now I will go to port F0/24 as a trunk port. Switch port mode trunk. Switch port switch port trunk allow VLAN 20, 30, and 100. VLAN 100 is a management VLAN. Okay, is a management VLAN. Let me create VLAN 20, VLAN 30, and VLAN 100 here. Okay, so now let me go to interface F0/1. I will switch this port mode to access, and this switch port access to VLAN 20 port number 1, and I will go to port number 2, switch port mode access, sorry, switch port mode access, switch port access VLAN 30. Okay, now done with the configuration of switch 4. Let me save the configuration. Okay, and wait, I need to assign the IP address. Switch 4 will have IP address 192.168.100.4/24. So Config-t, VLAN 100. VLAN 100 is the management VLAN so that a network engineer PCs can remote to this switch. So IP address 192.168.100.4, which is subnet mask 20/24. Okay, that's it. So now let me save. Done with switch 4. Now let me configure switch number 3. Okay, switch number 3. Enable. Config T. Hostname already switch 3 and no logging console. Line VTY 04. Enable the telnet password. Cisco. All devices I will assign password Cisco. Okay. Even the console also. I will put password Cisco. Okay. Okay, let me zoom. I forgot to zoom in so that you guys can see clearly. Okay, this is better for you. So yeah, login. Is it enable password also Cisco? Okay, let's configure switch number 3 here. This is a switch number 3 where we have ports 0/3 0/3 INT F0/3, which belong to VLAN 40. Oh wait, I forgot to create VLAN. How many VLAN we have here? VLAN 30, VLAN 40, and VLAN 100. Okay, VLAN 100, VLAN 30, VLAN 40, VLAN 100. Okay, and yes, I will go back to port number 3. Switch port mode access. Switch port mode access. Switch port access VLAN 40. Port number 4. Port number 4 VLAN 30. INT F0/4. Switch port mode access. Switch port access VLAN 30. Port number 5, INT F0/5. Switch port mode access. Switch port access VLAN 100. Sorry, switch port access VLAN 100. Okay, and I have having port trunk, which is 0/23 to another switch. So INT F0/23 switch port mode trunk and switch port trunk allow VLAN 30, 40, and 100. Okay, so these three VLANs we are having in this switch. So now let's assign the IP address for VLAN 100. IP 192.168.100.3 for switch 3/24. Okay, this is the IP for remote from network engineer PC. So yes, so now we're done with the configuration of switch number 3. Let's save it. Let's go to switch number 2. Switch number 2, we are having VLAN 20, VLAN 40, and VLAN 100 also. So yeah. So let's do this. Enable config T. No login console. Enable the password for telnet VTY04 password Cisco. And yeah, I think I forgot with switch number 3, I forgot to encryption the password. Yeah, config T service password encryption. Yeah, so now go back to switch number 2. Login is it. Now we enable the password. We already enable the password for telnet. Now let's enable password for console. Line console password also Cisco. Login and enable password also Cisco. Everything Cisco. So service password encryption, don't forget. So let's create VLAN 30, VLAN 40, yeah, I think VLAN 20, VLAN 40, VLAN 40 and VLAN 20 for switch number 2. We don't have VLAN 30. No, VLAN 30, VLAN 20 we have, and VLAN 100. Okay, so let's go to port number 7 is VLAN 20, F0/7, switch port mode access, switch port access VLAN 20, and port number 6, F0/6. Switch port mode access, sorry, and switch port access VLAN 40 for port number 6, and port trunk is 0/22. INT F0/22, switch port mode trunk. And switch port trunk allow VLAN 20, VLAN 40, and VLAN 100. Okay, so now we already done with the configuration for access and trunk for ports. Already ports. All ports, yeah, and then now we assign the IP address for VLAN 100, IP address 192.168.100.2, because it's switched to /24.255.255.0. Yeah, now done. Let's save switch 2. Yeah, now we go to switch number 1. Okay, enable config T and no login console. assign password for telnet line VTY04 password Cisco login is it, and also assign for console password Cisco login is it, enable secret also Cisco, and service password encryption. Yes, this switch no access port, so all are trunk ports. So yeah, we configure only for the trunk port. We are creating VLAN 20, VLAN 30, VLAN 40, VLAN 100. We are creating these four VLANs. So yeah, now let's go to port number 24, S0/24. Port number 24, we are having only two VLANs, 20 and 30. Okay, switch port mode trunk, switch port trunk allow VLAN 20 and 30. 20, 30 also include 100. Okay. Port number 23. INT F0/23. Switch port mode trunk. Switch port trunk allow VLAN 40, 30, and 100. VLAN 30, 40, and VLAN 100. Now we go to port F0/22. Switch port mode trunk. Switch port trunk allow VLAN 20, 40, and 100. Okay, now we done configuration for the switch port. So let's assign IP address, INT VLAN 100, IP 192.168.100.1/24. Okay, now we done configuration for four switches. Let's save the configuration. Yeah, let's now configure router. Okay, let's configure router. We are having two ports. So yeah, two ports. This port will be working as a sub interface for VLANs, because there are three VLANs, four VLANs, five VLANs, and how many VLANs you want, you can create sub interface here. So enable config T. I will change hostname to R1. I will go to port number 0/1. No shut. Then I will exit. So now let's configure sub interface for interface F0/1 in router. Okay. INT F0/1.20 encapsulation dot 1Q20 IP address 192.168.20.1/24. Okay, /24. Is it INT F0/1.30 encapsulation dot 1Q20 IP address. This is what belong to VLAN 30, 192.168.30.1/24. Okay, now configure another sub interface which belong to VLAN 40. IP address 192.168.40.1. Okay. Now let's configure another interface, another sub interface for VLAN 100. Okay. Okay, now we are done configuration for interface which is linked to the LAN network. So now let's configure this WAN interface. INT F0/0. I will use /30 for this link between these two routers. So this is the IP address. We are already in here. IP address 10.10.10.2/30 255 255 255 252. Sorry. Yeah. No shut. And I will use default routing protocol here. So IP route 0.0.0.0, subnet mask also 0.10.10.10.1. Okay, done. Let me save. Now let me configure this switch. Sorry, this router. Okay. I also use default routing protocol. Enable. Config T. INT F0/0. IP address 10.10.10.1. Here 10.10.1/30. 252. No shut. And I will go to interface F0/1, which is belong to LAN network 172.16.16.1. IP address 172.16.16.1/24. Okay. no shut. Okay, now let me configure no log jing, no log jing console. Sorry. No logging console, and also enable telnet VTY 04, password Cisco, login my mistake of typing, I'm sorry. Enable console, password Cisco, is it? Enable secret Cisco, service password encryption, and we save it. Okay, I forgot to assign the enable the telnet password here also. Line VTY 04, password Cisco, login, is it? Line console, password Cisco, login, is it? Enable password Cisco, and also enable this encryption password. Okay, now we save the configuration. Now we are done with the configuration. Let's start with this PC, VLAN 30. I assign this IP address. Gateway is the 30.1. So let's try to ping 192.168.30.1, which is the gateway. So first of all, we need to ping to gateway. Is it enabled to ping or not? Just wait. Is not able to ping. Ah, I am sorry. I forgot to configure this trunk G0/1. I'm sorry. This is the main trunk. INT G0/1 switch port mode trunk. This is the main trunk, I forgot. Switch port trunk allow VLAN 30, 20, 30, 40, and 100. Yeah, my mistake. Just wait. Let it green. Yeah, now it's green. So now let's ping again. Yeah. Okay, so let's try to access to the Google. I already enabled the DNS name www.google.com. Is able to access google.com or not? No. Ah. Yo. No routing here. IP route 0000000010.10.10.2, because I forgot. Sorry. again. Yeah, it's coming. Yeah. So let's change to VLAN 20 here. Let's assign IP 192.168.20.20 192.168.20.1 gateway. This is a DNS name, sorry, DNS IP address to access web page www.google.com. Yeah, we are working now. So yeah, let's check this computer. This is the engineer computer. They can telnet to all switches. Telnet 192.168.100.1. Yeah. Now we are accessing PC, sorry, switch number one, Cisco. Enable Cisco. Yeah. So yeah, we are done. Thank you for watching this video. I will configure more. Yeah, before I finish, let me ping to all switches. Switch 1 from network engineer PC. Switch number 2. Working. Switch number 3. Also working. And switch number 4. Working. And I ping to router interface 100.254. This is the router interface, router sub interface. If not working, we will find out what happened. Let me try again. It should working. Did I assign IP address in the router here? Oh, I assigned number 1, not number 100. So config t int f0/1.100 IP address. IP address 192.168.1.254.255.255.255.0. Let me override the address 100. Okay. Save the configuration. Let me ping again. Yeah, because I assigned wrong address. Okay, thank you for watching the video. Please do subscribe to see more exercises and more lessons. So thank you.